Hello everybody. Today is a special full day of meals because it is all inspired by my new cookbook. So Katie surprised me and got me this a little while ago. And this is a first edition from the 1950s cookbook. So inside, let me show you. Inside has a section, meal planning and nutrition. So in here it has sample meal plans. What is suggested, borrow these and have dinner, breakfast, and lunch. They suggest all of them. So I thought how fun to follow their whole day. So like we did Swiss steak. So then you come over here and you pick one of these, baked potatoes or scallop potatoes, and then you pick asparagus or julienne beets. And you go on over to the salad and the dessert and nice to serve with. So it does that for breakfast. It does it for lunch. Like lunches your family would like. Then it also even has lunchbox ideas. I just absolutely, absolutely, absolutely love this book. So fun. Look at how sweet. I love it. I'm so an old-fashioned girl, and I love the old-fashioned everything. So, that being said, what we did was we decided, now this is actually yesterday that I did it and I filmed. We decided to spend the whole day eating like it was from the 1950s. So I made and followed specifically that meal plan. So I did a breakfast, a lunch, and a dinner from that meal plan. So that way I knew it was exactly what was suggested to eat at that time. Somebody's coming in and out the door. It's going to happen. It's a beautiful day here. So I actually, though, didn't get a lot of me or the family on film yesterday. So I'm going to kind of just jump in today and put my words to it because we were dealing with sickness and we have another one down with strep throat. So I had to go to the doctor yesterday and sit and wait with that and get her on her antibiotics. Ronnie is the one who is now down. So fingers crossed, only Theo and Ronnie, and we don't have any more issues with the strep. But you never know. So let's go on and jump into breakfast. Here's breakfast. Okay, so this is actually Friday night. And we're gonna go on and start the buckwheat pancakes because it says that it gets mixed up at night and sits out on the counter then until morning, and then you add the final ingredients and cook it up. So let's go down and throw this like buckwheat pancake batter together. Starting with lukewarm water. Yeast. Sugar, giving that a stir. Then in a separate bowl, we're going to add our dry ingredients. Buckwheat flour, all-purpose flour, salt, stir that up, and then we're going to add that to the yeast mixture and stir it up.
Okay, so here it is now, and we're gonna just cover it up. Okay, so here I switch bowls because it says that it's gonna rise really big, and I make sure that the bowl is at least no more than halfway full, lower the better. And it didn't say to cover it, but I'm just gonna go on and cover it anyway. You don't want anything to get in it. And then it says just leave it sit room temperature until morning. So just leave it sit out, do its thing. That's what we're gonna do. I've never made pancakes like this in my life. See how it turns out. Also, I just wanted to say I've had so much fun going through this and coming up with this. But if tomorrow goes the way I think it is, make sure you guys give this a thumbs up and let me know down below if you want me to continue with the 1950s for the rest of the week and just do a 1950s week, other than Two for Tuesday, of course, because we are collabing, unless somehow I can figure that out and still make it a 1950s meal. But yeah, let me know if that's something you guys would like to see, if this is like something you want. I'm learning so much, and I'm definitely going to take away a lot from this. Like, we so nowadays do not eat near enough fruits and vegetables. Just, we don't. And I think we do good, but they eat a lot more than we do. So I'm actually going to probably try and follow this as close as I can for just for a week or so. So if you guys want more 1950s meals, let me know. Hello, everybody. Good morning. It is 7:30 in the morning, and I need to get the bread started for lunch. So yes, I'm not cleaned up or anything yet, but living in the 1950s, I would have to get my own bread ready. So I'm gonna get that ready for lunch, and then I'll move into probably making breakfast. The kids, everybody is still sleeping. Ronnie had a fever last night, so we'll see how things go today. But gonna go on and make the sandwich bread. So of course I'm using the recipe from the cookbook. So here's how we're gonna make it.
Okay, and once again we're gonna start off with our warm water and our yeast. And while that's getting nice and bubbly, we're gonna go on and do our milk, sugar, salt, and shortening. And we're gonna heat that over a medium-high heat until the milk is scalded and just before it starts to boil. Then we're gonna let that cool down to room temperature and add that to our yeast mixture. Before we add it to our yeast mixture, though, we're going to go on and add 2 cups of flour to the milk mixture. Stir that together and then add that to the yeast mixture along with the rest of the flour. And you're going to let that just stir with the dough hook on low and let it knead it for about 8 minutes.
Said one. come for. Said all you got, gotta give it to me, baby, now. All right.
And now we're going to move into our buckwheat pancakes. So stir the batter from last night. Into that, add 2 tablespoons of brown sugar and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. Stir that all together. And then over in your pan, you're going to heat some butter to melted and just cook them up like normal pancakes.
Okay, so I know that they did not have, you know, all the modern stuff of today, but I'm trying to follow the recipes and not live the lifestyle. So, but definitely trying to make like they did the recipes and stuff, but like I did use my electric mixer to do the kneading instead of me kneading it. And here is hot chocolate on the stove. I just added cocoa powder, sugar, and milk. That's it. And it says to serve with either milk, coffee, or hot chocolate. So that's what we got. Okay, so here it is, our 1950s breakfast. So everybody has grapefruit, and then there is the buckwheat pancakes, warm syrup, bacon, and then the kids are all having hot chocolate. I already had my coffee, so I'm not gonna have anything. Okay, so our bread is risen. It says punch it down. And then we're going to let this rise a second time. So just cover and let it rise. It says about another 45 minutes. So now it's been 45 minutes and we're going to go on and punch down the dough for the second time and divide it into 2 loaves. Then roll the loaf into a rectangle. And just like you would do a jelly roll, you're going to roll it towards you and tuck the sides or ends under and put it in your bread pan. And then cover the bread pan and let that rise for about another hour.
Okay, and now for lunch. All right, these are ready for the oven.
All right, so part of lunch is dessert. So for dessert, we're doing baked apples. So I'm just coring the middle with a melon baller. And once I got all the cores out, then I'm gonna put a cup of water into the pan. Filling each apple with brown sugar. I started to use a measuring spoon, but switched to a baby spoon, and that worked perfect. And then put a pat of butter on top of the brown sugar and push it into the apple best you can, and bake these at 375
degrees for about 45 minutes. Okay, so here is the homemade bread. You guys, it turned out so good. Cut beautifully. Cheese on some, ham on some. I did not have enough ham and cheese to make for both. The girls just wanted cheese and we just wanted ham. So I'm gonna put these in and bake them so that they get all melty like an open-faced sandwich. All right, and this is our lunch. Baked apples. Carrots and celery, chips, and then open face sandwiches. And I will grab some mayonnaise and some mustard to go with that also. Last but not least, dinner. So the first thing we're gonna do is make the syrup to go with our strawberry sundaes for dessert. So I'm just taking some frozen strawberries, a cup of sugar, a couple tablespoons of lemon juice, and that's it. Just cook it and cook it and cook it and stir it on a medium low. And while that's cooking, I'm getting the Swiss steak ready. So I'm gonna start with some flour, salt, and pepper in a bowl. And then I'm going to coat my cube steak with the flour mixture. Just kind of really work it in there. And then I am heating up my lard in a dish. You can use a Dutch oven. I'm using my cast iron pot here. And you also, you don't need to use lard. You could use Crisco or you could use bacon grease or anything. Just you want to brown your meat real good. And then I'm adding my onion and getting all the bits off the bottom. And then I will add the meat back in.
I'd say that I'm a loner.
And then you're going to top it with a can of diced tomatoes. Cover that, and that goes in the oven, cooked with the cover for an hour and a half to 2 hours, 350 degrees. So while that's cooking, I went ahead and started on the scallop potatoes. So you want to peel your potatoes and slice them very thin. It called for 6 medium potatoes, but I had a bunch of little potatoes and only a few small potatoes.
And the match that drew a spark was a single stolen kiss. And if that ain't love, I don't know what is. For years I've kept my feelings grounded and gone without all care.
Then it's time to make the sauce. So start by melting 3 tablespoons of butter, and then you're going to add 2 tablespoons of flour. Stir that up real good, and you're going to let it cook for a little bit just to kind of brown the flour. That keeps your sauce from tasting like it's just flour. After that's cooked and browned a little bit, then add your milk. You're going to add 3 cups of milk. Just slowly add your milk.
The match that drew the spark
single and stolen kiss. And if that ain't love, I don't know what is. If that ain't love.
And then add your salt and pepper. And you're going to go on and cook this until it becomes thickened. It doesn't need to be really thick like gravy, but just thickened. It will thicken more as it cooks in the oven. And then once that's thick, you're going to start with half your potatoes in your casserole dish. Pour half the sauce on top. And then top it with a few thinly sliced red onion. And then you're going to add the rest of your potatoes and the rest of your sauce. Top that with the last bit of onion, cover it, and it's going to bake covered for an hour and then uncovered just until the tops brown a little bit. And lastly, we're going to get the asparagus ready. I'm just drizzling some olive oil. It really didn't have a recipe for me to follow in the cookbook, so I just made it the way we always do. A little olive oil, salt, and pepper. So here is tonight's dinner. So the other loaf of the homemade bread. This really did turn out just like sandwich bread. And it is we are gonna make it all the time. The Swiss steak. So you have the cube steak in here, like that. And then the onion and tomatoes. The scalloped potatoes, asparagus, and then our salad tonight is it was supposed to be orange endive salad, and then it's got a vinaigrette on it that is just olive oil, vinegar, and sugar, and a little bit of garlic, and I did not have endive, and I could not find it, so I just used a green leaf lettuce. That's dinner tonight. And this is tonight's dessert, strawberry sundaes. We are out of whipped cream. That's the homemade strawberry sauce and ice cream. And what was your favorite thing today in our day of eating of the 50s?
I like the strawberry sundae and the scalloped potatoes. They're really good.
All right, Ashie, what was your favorite part?
The ice cream.
Chair is missing here. Ronnie had chicken noodle soup and then went back up to bed because she is sick. Kate, favorite part?
The pancakes and the apples.
Pancakes and the apples? Honey, who's been cutting down bushes and everything else today, what's your favorite part?
I would say the sandwiches this afternoon were really good, but the ice cream takes the cake. Or ice cream.
Of course you're going to say ice cream.
It's my one true love.
So what all did I take away from this? What did we like? What did we not like? Would we do it again? I showed you what everybody's favorites were at dinner last night. So my favorite thing, I'd have to say, was the baked apples. They were really good and so easy to do. But the strawberry syrup was wonderful too. The strawberry jam type syrup was fabulous too. So I don't know. I really liked it all. So what I took away from it, though, is they lived in the kitchen. Like, for real.
I think that is so much time in the kitchen. But I guess if you just get in your groove, kind of like when I started cooking everything from scratch, I felt like I'm so in the kitchen all the time. But I think if you get in your groove, then you're not really going to feel like you're in the kitchen all the time. And I think it would definitely be doable once you could figure it out. I loved the variety that they have of fruits and vegetables at all the meals. They followed 7 food groups versus 5. So they had like a food group specific just for yellow and green vegetables. There was a salad at every dinner. They did relish trays at dinner. Well, you know, we really kind of dove into it when she got me this book a few weeks ago and just started really digging into what did they eat? What was it like? I mean, that's in my grandmother's time, so I really need to go interview my grandma. She was so a 1950s mom. My mother was born in the 50s. And I need to go through all her old recipes. I definitely need to do that. So I think I'm going to interview her and probably do another one of these. So make sure you give a thumbs up if you like this and you want to see another one of these, because I think it would be fun to do another one and kind of interview my grandmother and go through some of her old cookbooks. And she's been wanting me to come over and go through them all anyway. And I think that would be a lot of fun. Let me know what you guys think. And if you are were a 1950s mom or a child of the 1950s and you remember what your mom would make, let me know how close we were. Because like I said, we followed the book specifically. This book was printed. It's not like somebody redid it. It's got old writing in it where they wrote in it, because it's a used book, you know. So it has like where they wrote their own recipes and notes. Whoever owned this book, which gives it so much character. And I love old things way more than new things. I love old things. And it was just so much fun. So hopefully you guys enjoyed this. And I will see you guys on Tuesday for a 2 for Tuesday. I hope you guys all have a blessed and wonderful weekend. Bye, everybody.